As usual, when I'm out hunting in the morning, I'm seeing tracks. Just for the record, in the zombie apocalypse, I'm pretty sure I would have had dinner right there. But Brendan said the law is you can only shoot a buck if it has one fork at least. And in fishing game lore, that fork must be large enough to hang your ring on. Kind of think that one was right in there, but I wasn't going to risk it. I'm going to get a nice big buck with a huge rack where I don't have to sit there and go, can I hang my ring on that? I don't even have a ring.
Hi, I'm calling to inquire to see if you're going to be open after midnight at some point on the night, the morning of September 22nd. 24/7. Okay, that makes us very happy because my brother's been starving himself for a year trying to survive off the land, and his first meal back in civilization is going to be at your establishment.
That's awesome.
We might be in a limo.
Alrighty, we'll see you guys later.
We'll see you.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye. We're in business.
Nice. Jack in the Box will be open. It may surprise everyone that this is my first year really attempting to grow corn. Like I said, I actually really wasn't that much of a gardener before. And so I would consider myself successful this year growing corn. One thing that I read is since it's wind pollinated, you gotta make sure that the male part, the top of the corn, ends up down on your little corn stalks. But like when the silky hair is there, these are already pollinated. So I've been bending them over, just tapping them like this on these like tufts of silk, which is why you want to grow corn in blocks or rows, and you can't just grow like one corn plant very well. But besides that, I really had no idea how to tell when corn is actually ripe. I had a source tell me that when that silk hair basically dies back, then you have sweet corn. And then when it continues and it completely dies back, then that actually just becomes like regular corn. Apparently once it really starts to set seed, all those sugars in the corn become starches. So depending on what you want, you can harvest it at different times. You can see here the end didn't get pollinated. That's kind of the problem I was talking about with not growing corn like really tightly in like huge blocks. This thing with my tooth is continuing to bother me. It's like actually like in my jaw, not my tooth, since there's not a tooth there. My jaw just kind of aches. I've been rinsing my mouth with half water, half hydrogen peroxide, and warm salt water, and I seem to be like knocking it back, and it'll feel okay for a little while, and then it'll come back. So just hopefully I can nurse this through another 48 days. And then go see the dentist.
I'm down here gathering the sea lettuce, which is like my favorite thing ever, and it finally ran out of best flavoring around. I bet you thought I forgot about the poke holes. Nope. I gotta catch something with this thing. My mom and I have come out and we're gonna try and get some fish out of these holes in the rock. Apparently with poke poling, you basically wanna take your pole and stick it in a hole and just let it wash around in there. Just continue moving on to different holes. So I found a hole here, let's see if I catch it. Looks like I was unsuccessful. So far, I'm still a really lousy fisherman. I caught my first fish of the day. First fish poke poling ever.
Keep throwing these back, but they keep eating all my bait off. You'd make such good bait, guy. Don't keep eating it. You might become it. I just caught something. No way. Check it out. I am fisherman. What the hell is it? It appears to be an eel. So that's going home. That's dinner. Successful poke pulling at last. Oh my god. Satisfaction. Also, check out how much sea lettuce I got. That stuff's like absolute gold to me. Here's one of three eels that I caught today, which I've never caught before. In fact, I haven't caught many fish, I guess. But I was pretty surprised to see this thing come out of that hole. And apparently, there's actually a best way to fillet an eel. That was totally awesome. The skin just peeled inside out and just came right off. Now we're just gonna flay down the sides here. There you go. And that's how it's done. Nice white meat, no bones. I definitely recommend this technique for flaying eels. They're pretty slimy. I guess that's where that saying slippery as an eel comes from. Doesn't make it any easier. Alright. That's actually quite good. Nice, tender, white meat. Guess what? It tastes like fish. But it tastes like good fish. Eel is definitely on the post-apocalyptic menu.
Oh my god. Holy shit. Oh. It appears that there were some deer eating my dad's avocados. He's not gonna be very happy about that. None of them were nice bucks though. Maybe in a couple years I can get one of those guys. Finally make my buckskin pants.
Who would have ever thought that skinning an eel would come in handy?